I'm going to show you a durable, deep research workflow built in Temporal. The first thing I'm going to do is provide a research topic, marsupials. And when I kick that off, it's going to start my Temporal workflow here in the Temporal UI on the right. You'll notice the first thing it did is run the triage agent to decide on what clarifying questions it wants to ask me. It asks what specific information about marsupials I'm interested in, their habitats, and scientific info. And once I hit enter on that answer, you'll see that I am interacting with the workflow through something called a workflow update. So workflows can sit here waiting for my answer forever, for days, months, years, and I can interact with them freely. The next question I got is, are you looking for scientific research, general knowledge, or something else related to marsupials? I'm going to say research, some general knowledge. And you'll notice that this time when I hit enter, it has gone red. So what is wrong with this clarification process? What is wrong with the API call that is processing my clarification? Well, there is a simulated failure. Try again soon. It looks like the downstream API is not available, and Temporal hopefully is retrying this by a retry policy over and over again until the API comes back. And so if I sit here and wait a little bit, you'll notice that, yes, the process clarification API has been rescued on the fourth attempt, and we're back in action. Before I give my final answer, which will kick off the research, I want to show you a little bit of what's happening behind the scenes. This is my architecture. On the right, the UI that you see is from the Temporal service. It's managing queues, timers, retries, and the state of the application. And its job is to orchestrate the work that's being done. And on the left is my application. I'm running a workflow that does all this deep research flow, accepts my clarifying questions, implemented in the Temporal SDK. The Temporal service doesn't need to see any code. Now, in reality, you're going to run several workers for scale, for reliability. And so what happens if those workers go down? So when I kick off the research run, I'm going to stop my workers, and then let's see how Temporal is durable in the face of failure. All right, so I've kicked off my research run here. There it is. A bunch of searches have been kicked off, scouring the internet for answers. And I'm actually just going to stop these workers that are running that workflow and those searches. You'll see that a few searches succeeded, but the rest of them should fail because literally the code that is running this agent has stopped. So you might think that this agent is lost. The progress is lost. There is no hope of it ever succeeding again. And you have to run all of those expensive LLM calls and all of that time-consuming work again. But in reality, if I revive my workers, there you go, I'm starting them again. The Temporal workflow should just continue as if nothing went wrong in the first place. And so there it is. You're seeing these search agents recovering as if nothing ever went wrong. And in fact, we've got up to our last step, which is collating all of this search information and writing a nice report about it. And there you have it, a beautiful research report completed, including a cute little ChatGPT image generation based on the topic. Note that ChatGPT images is actually using Temporal under the hood, so the real ChatGPT images. And here is my nice, well-structured research report on marsupials, kangaroos, koalas, and scientific info. So thank you very much. That was Temporal surviving in the face of a multitude of failures. No work was lost. The research continued. And now we have a beautiful research report. Thank you very much.